tiramisu, I cannot tell that those are Tuscan recipes, those are just Italian, but it was so nice to put some of those recipes in the book as well. And most important part will be the first chapter, where you will see all the pictures black and white of my family. Because this, more than a cookbook, is a book about the stories of a family that lives every day on the farm. You will see that each chapter is shared by months, so it's January, February, and March, not just chapter. And each month talk about the seasonal products and about what's going on at the farm every month. But still, the main chapter for me is the first one, where you will see all the picture and in black and white, because my parents were farmers from generation, and they were actually poor farmers. So it's a story of a hard worker, people that spent all their life working in the farm. They moved in the 1955 to work as a chef proper. Wine tasting that you can do every time with friends or family, and it will help you to recognize if you have a good wine or not. How we can do this wine tasting? We just need to have a glass of wine. You can do with any kind of wine you want. It might be white, red, sparkling wine, sweet wine, it doesn't matter. There are always the same three steps. So the first one will be take a look at the color. We try to have our glass in between our eyes and the light. We can see that we have a very beautiful yellow gold color. And that's the color that we are looking for in a young white wine like we have tonight. And this is 2011. Just wanted to remind you that 2011 is the youngest available, because 2012, we did harvest the grapes this September, 2012, but the wine will be ready the next year, around March or April. So that will have the vintage 2012. So that's the most recent available. That's very good, because usually the white wine doesn't have that long life. So it's always better drink the white wine when they are a little bit younger. So the second step will be smell the wine. We smell the wine, we try to feel the flavors that are coming out of the glass. Sometimes when you do the first time, you don't feel that much flavor. Well, first of all, the vernaccia doesn't have so many flavors, but that's not a bad thing. That's the vernaccia. These grapes is like this. But sometimes also when you have old red wine aged in the barrels, when you smell, you cannot that feel so much right away. So you just need to move the glass in this way. Give it a little rotation. So the wine is getting a little bit of oxygenation and it's breathing. So after a few seconds, you stop and you re-smell right away. When you re-smell, can you feel it? There are more flavors that are coming out of the glass in our nose compared to the first time we did it. So those flavors are very similar, or by the way, they remind us some kinds of fruits and flavors and flowers, sorry. We are trying to describe this wine in some way. We don't want it to use the particular things to describe the wine, like alcohol percentage, sugar percentage. We want it to be able to talk about the wine, even with people that doesn't know that much about the wine. So how we can do? We just compare the flavors that are coming out of the glass to flavors that we already know, and they are in our brain, because we already smell in the morning, eating our breakfast, or smelling a bouquet of flowers, or flavors that we already know in our life. So the flavors in the vernaccia are very similar to the fresh green apple. So this acidity that you will also find in your mouth is very similar to the fresh green apple, and some kind of yellow wild flower that are typical in the spring and summertime in our fields. One of those is the ginestra, but you have to come to the farm to smell the ginestra. So finally, we have the third step. This is always the best one. So before we drink, we say salute, and we finally drink our wine. So we drink a little bit of our wine, and we feel there's a dry wine. There's nothing sweet, there's no sugar in our mouth. We might feel a little bit of fruity flavor, but this is coming from the grapes, from the wine, it's not sugar. And now probably you can feel a little bit better the green apple, the acidity that is very similar to when you buy to the green apple. And it's a salty, there is a little bit of salt in this one. I'm not talking about regular salt. It's just a mineral taste that is coming from the soil of our area. It feels around San Gimignano are rich of seashell and mineral soil. So for this reason, we have this kind of salty taste in our mouth. And we can recognize this because we have a lot of saliva in our mouth. So this is why it's coming from.
So what you do is you do a little massage to the meat in this way. So the meat will absorb everything. Now, in the recipe, you will find all the right ingredients and all the timing and everything. I just wanted to show you a little bit of a demonstration. In the recipe, it's also explained how you should tie the meat, but since we are doing a little bit of the demonstration, we want to make everything more easy, easier and faster. So you can even do this version. We put in a skillet, and then we add our three ingredients. They are onions, carrots, and celery. So you will see it's such a simple recipe with very good and healthy ingredients. So we mix all three ingredients together. Don't worry if they go on top of the turkey, it's not a problem. So again, carrots, onion, and then celery. And just remember, since we season only the turkey, we need to season a little bit of the vegetable too. So we add a little bit of salt for the vegetable. And I will start to cook. So for a little bit bigger piece of turkey, and the recipe is 1 kilogram of meat, even a little bit more, don't worry, it's all in pounds and measuring cups, so I'm talking with kilograms and grams because I'm more familiar with that. But in the book you will find all with the measuring, with the American measurement.